A very good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss about antiarrhythmic agents. This is about the disease that is related with the disturbance in the rhythm of heart pulses. So all this particular antihypertensive drug, antiarrhythmic drug, anti-anginal, all this related with the heart diseases. If any disturbance with respect to any cause and it reflects changes in the pattern or the system of heart functioning. So antiarrhythmic agents, these are the agents are a group of drugs that are used to suppress abnormal rhythm of the heart, that is also known as cardiac arrhythmia, such as atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter, ventricular tachycardia and ventricular fibrillation. Or we can say this antiarrhythmic drug can modify impulse generation and conduction. So overall, the condition that is related with the rhythm of the heart. So with such type of condition, the rhythm of heart will disturb. So that can be controlled or that can be modified with the use of this antiarrhythmic agents, or we can say antiarrhythmic drugs. So cardiac arrhythmias are the abnormalities in the rate, regularity or site of origin of the cardiac impulse, or disturbances in conduction of the impulse such that the normal sequence of activation of atria and ventricles are altered. It means here it's written very clearly, or it's very very specific one. Okay, generally we all know that heartbeats, that is 72 to 74 per minute. So with respect to anything, whether the function of atria or ventricles, that is altered by some way that directly reflect with the conduction of the impulses, and so the rhythm of heart will disturb. That is dysarrhythmia, we can say. That is all known as cardiac arrhythmia, or we can say the abnormality with the rhythm of heart pulses. Here the picture, a beautiful picture and explanation, that is also in a very beautiful way, arrhythmia, where A separately, then IA, then the word rhythm, that is highlighted. So this is well explained rhythm, arrhythmia, and definition is a deviation of heart from the normal rhythm. Here in picture, heart is shown various part of the heart that is related with pumping of blood and normal functioning of heart and heartbeats and all that. So all these particular nodes are mentioned, that is included with the normal rhythm of heart. So here you can see that sinoatrial node, atrioventricular node, then left, there are four chambers in the heart that we all know. So that is also here shown very clearly. So rhythm, that is the normal heart rate, is a range that is 60 to 100, that is the normal range. But if it is lower than 60 or above than 100, then it is abnormality in the heart rates. So it should origin from SAN, that is sinoatrial node. Then cardiac impulse should propagate through normal conduction pathway with normal velocity. Here a heartbeat that is too fast is called tachycardia, whereas the opposite of this, that is known as ki heartbeat that is too low, is called bradycardia. So too low, it means that is lower than 60, and fast, it means higher than 100. So this two, the particular range, extremities, means the border way, the lower border as well as the hard, higher border, as per that it falls under two category, tachycardia and bradycardia. This is about the rhythm of heart. Here the very full chart of heart, artery, pulmonary veins, different types of veins are there, then pulmonary artery, aorta, and all this that is included for the normal functioning of heart as well as heart rate rhythm. So here you can see that sinoatrial node, with each heartbeat the electric impulse begin at the SA node, that is located in the right atrium, and the SA node produces the electric impulses that set the rate and rhythm of heartbeat. The electrical activity spreads through the wall of atria and causes them to contract. So this is about the function of SA, ki how it is involved for the normal functioning and normal heart rate, and how all this contraction takes place that is responsible for the heart beating. The next one important part, that is atrioventricular node, that is also known as AV node. So the AV node is located between the atria and ventricles and acts like a gate that shows the electrical signal before it enters the ventricle. This delay gives the atria time to contract before the ventricles do. It's like a step by step rhythm. So one function over, then automatically it switches to another one. So in this way, normal rhythms are maintained in human body. Then His-Purkinje network, this pathway of fibers sends the impulse into the muscular wall of the ventricles and causes them to contract. This contraction forces blood out of the heart to the lung and body. See, heart is the center part where all this function takes place and pumping of blood, and so it reaches to the various parts of the body so that normal function of body can be taken out, right? If any disturbance in that case, blood not reaches to that particular site, deficiency arise, and that is responsible for we feel fatigue. જેને આપણે એવું કહીએ છીએ થાક લાગવો, મૂડ નથી લાગતો, સમટાઇમ્સ વી ફીલ લાઈક બોરિંગ. દેટ ઇઝ ઓલ અબાઉટ ધીસ, કે આઈધર ઓક્સિજન ઇઝ નોટ સફિશિયન્ટલી રીચ ટુ દેટ પર્ટિક્યુલર એરિયા, ઓર ઓક્સિજન ઇઝ નોટ ઇન અ એડિક્યુએટ અમાઉન્ટ, મીન્સ ડિમાન્ડ કે હિસાબ સે સપ્લાય નહીં હો રહા હૈ. તો ધીસ ઇઝ ધ રીઝન કે ફંક્શનિંગ મેં કુછ ગડબડ હો રહા હૈ. ધ એસ એ નોડ ફાઈબર્સ અનધર ઇમ્પલ્સ the SA node fires another impulse and the cycle begins again. So it's like a cycle one by one, and so heart rate normal that 72 beats or 60 to 100, that regulates or that going on. Then in terms of pharmacological way, this is called rhythmic disorders. So this rhythm disorders are treated with medications that normalize the heart rate by affecting the nervous system that controls the heart rate. So ultimately it's nothing but the where we can control or regulate the rhythmic of heartbeats, that is known as antiarrhythmic agents or antiarrhythmic drugs, because that controlled antiarrhythmia. Okay, so this is also known as rhythm disorders, or to treat such a disorder, whatever the medications are used are known as antiarrhythmic drugs, or we can say antiarrhythmic agents. Here, medication for this particular disorder generally or most frequently used, that is beta blockers or calcium channel blockers, are clinically useful. Other category of drugs are also available for this, but clinically these two are most frequently used if such type of condition arise. Now the conduction system, this particular part we have explained in very detail in previous two slides. So the same way here, conduction system, how conduction takes place, the same way, that is sinoatrial node to then atrial syncretium, then junctional fiber, atrioventricular node, then AV bundle, then bundle branches, then Purkinje fiber, and finally trigger to ventricular syncytium, and so normal conduction function takes place. The heart's pacemaker, એવું કદાચ ખ્યાલ હોય તો, if you have any idea, a person having problem with a heart disease, બલૂન લગાવ્યું, એન્જિયોપ્લાસ્ટી કરાવ્યું, પેસમેકર ફિટ કરાવ્યું. સો વાય ધીસ પેસમેકર એન્ડ વોટ ઇઝ ધ નીડ ઓફ ઇટ? તો હાર્ટ પેસમેકર કોઝિસ રેગ્યુલર કોન્ટ્રેક્શન ઓફ ધ માયોકાર્ડિયમ, મીન્સ અલ્ટિમેટલી ઇટ રેગ્યુલેટ્સ ધ હાર્ટ રિધમ. સો હાર્ટ પેસમેકર કોઝિસ રેગ્યુલર કોન્ટ્રેક્ટિંગ ઓફ ધ માયોકાર્ડિયમ દેટ રિઝલ્ટિંગ ઇન ટુ અ રેગ્યુલર હાર્ટબીટ ઓર પલ્સ. સો હિયર ઇન અ કોન્ટ્રેક્શન ફેઝિસ,
First is the polarization, that is the resting part, and repolarization, that is recharging part. And the third one that is intermediate, that is depolarization, that is in between, is known as contracting phase. So initially that is the resting, then after contraction takes place and again come back to its original one, that is the repolarization state. So all of you know that whenever such type of drugs are given, if tachycardia is a condition, it means heart beats, it's so fast. In that case, what we need to do, that particular rhythm need to be in a relaxed mood. So via this particular medication, it gives repolarization and again come back to the normal position. Now, what are the different causes that are actually responsible for disturbance in the rhythm of heartbeats? That is also known as heart arrhythmia. So, the causes of heart arrhythmia, or what particular causes responsible for abnormal heartbeat? So, first one, heart attack. This is the very drastic one. Then damaged heart due to a prior attack. Then disease conditions like cardiomyopathy, then coronary artery disease, hypertension, chronic hypertension. As we all know, people are taking tablets since last 20 years, 25 years, because it started in early age, like 40 or 50 nowadays. Initially it was like it starts above 50 years of age, but nowadays it's narrow down that particular range, and nowadays it starts from the age of 30 years. So if it started at 30 and reaches to like 60 years of age, then it's a very chronic one, the 30 years of this antihypertensive drug uses. So in that case, definitely the heartbeat of that particular person will be changed or disturbing the rhythm of heartbeat. So hypertension, then diabetes mellitus, hyperthyroidism, then hypothyroidism, then tobacco abuse. See, all this particular condition where one or the other way, ultimately it affects the normal hormonal level. So in case we can say, like, if hormonal level disturb, that also indirectly affect the heartbeat rate. So then tobacco abuse, alcohol or caffeine abuse, recreational drug use, excessive stress, certain classes of medications can also cause heart arrhythmia, certain dietary supplements, then it can also cause heart damage, arrhythmias, or electric shock. So these are the few conditions, a list of condition exactly, responsible for the disturbance in the rhythm of heart, and so heart arrhythmia is generated. Here, these are the symptoms for heart disease or disturbance in heart rate or heartbeats. First one, that is a fluttering in your chest, then a racing heartbeat. It means increased heartbeat. Generally, we feel with jhadapthi daudina avu, kudine chadvu. In that case, heartbeat increased. So, racing heartbeat, tachycardia, a slow heartbeat, bradycardia. Then chest pain, then shortness of breath. જ્યાં તમને એવું લાગે કે તમને હાર્ટ બ્રીધિંગ લેવામાં પ્રોબ્લેમ થઈ રહ્યો છે, એન્ડ ઇન દેટ કેસ યુ નીડ ટુ ટેક કન્ટિન્યુઅસ લાઇક દેટ. સો ઇટ્સ અ શોર્ટનેસ ઓફ બ્રીથ. દેન લાઇટ હેડેડનેસ, કન્ટિન્યુઅસલી યુ ફીલ લાઈક દેટ કે તમારા માથામાં કંઈક ભૂંકાઈ રહ્યું છે, ઓર લાઈક કંઈક માથા પર વજન મૂકી દીધું છે, લાઈક દેટ. સો ધેન નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ ડિઝીનેસ એન્ડ ફેન્ટિંગ. ફેન્ટિંગ લાઈક બેભાન અવસ્થાની પહેલાંનું, ઇટ્સ નોટ લાઈક કમ્પ્લીટલી તમે ફેન્ટ થઈ જાઓ. સો હિયર દેસ આર ધ મેઇન સિમ્ટમ્સ ફોર ધીસ પર્ટિક્યુલર કન્ડિશન. હિયર ઇન ડાયાગ્રામ, હિયર ઇન ધીસ પિક્ચર, ઇટ શોઝ અધર કન્ડિશન્સ ટુ કોરોનરી હાર્ટ ડિસીઝ એન્જાઇના. That is dull or heavy to sharp chest pain, discomfort, then pain in neck also, jaw, throat, upper abdomen or back, backside. Generally what happen, most of the time muscular pain is also there, but here the difference between muscular pain and pain that is associated with
this particular disturbance in heartbeat. So that is, this particular pain is a radiating. It means it starts from the left hand side, from the your heart, and it's like apne what we can say, jhipkara marwa, kind of that kind of pain that is associated with this particular disorders or disease condition. And the normal pain muscular, that is very clear that you can identify, but still it is very difficult at early stage when people cannot identify. Okay, jaw line neck, jya tame u kocho ka apro akho bhag અહીંયા થી મતલબ ઉપર નેક પોર્શન થી લઈને હાથ આખો જકડાઈ ગયો છે. સમટાઈમ્સ ઇટ ઇઝ ડ્યુ ટુ સ્લીપિંગ હેબિટ્સ ઓલ્સો, બટ ઇન અર્લી સિમ્ટમ્સ, ધીસ ઇઝ કોલ્ડ અર્લી સિમ્ટમ્સ, પર્ટિક્યુલરલી વિથ કોરોનરી હાર્ટ ડિસીઝીસ, વેર હોલ લેફ્ટ હેન્ડ પોર્શન દેટ ઇઝ લાઈક અ વેરી ટાઈટનિંગ એન્ડ પેન એન્ડ ઓલ દેટ. દેન હાર્ટ એટેક, ચેસ્ટ પેન ઓર ડિસકમ્ફર્ટ, દેન અપર બેક ઓર નેક પેન, દેન ઇન્ડાઇજેશન, હાર્ટ બર્ન, જેવી રીતે આપણને એસિડિટીમાં વી ફીલ લાઈક બળે છે, તો ઇનિશિયલ લેવલ ઓફ હાર્ટ એટેક, ઇન દેટ કેસ ઓલ્સો હાર્ટ બર્ન, દેન નોઝિયા એન્ડ વોમિટિંગ, દેન એક્સ્ટ્રીમ ફેટિક, જ્યાં તમને એવું લાગે છે કે નાઉ આઈ એમ કમ્પ્લીટલી એક્ઝોસ્ટેડ, કે હમણાં હું આમ પડી જઈશ, લાઈક દેટ. સો અપર બોડી ડિસકમ્ફર્ટ, શોર્ટનેસ ઓફ બ્રીથ, દેન એરિથમિયા, દેટ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ ધ ફ્લટરિંગ, ઇટ્સ ફીલિંગ લાઈક પાલ્પિટેશન્સ. Heart failure, that is again related with the shortness of breath. Swelling in feet, ankles, that is nothing due to disturbance or dysfunctioning of kidneys, and so fluid and water retention is there, that is responsible for swelling. Then fatigue, then antiarrhythmic drugs. Here is the classification for that. Here, based on the particular phase, like it works on that particular four phases, heartbeats, જેમાં આપણે એવું કહીએ છીએ ઇલેક્ટ્રોકાર્ડિયોગ્રામ, જેમાં ઇમ્પલ્સ ઇટ સ્ટાર્ટ ફ્રોમ PQRS પોઈન્ટ. ડૉક્ટર પાસે ક્યારેક ગયા હશો, ક્યારેક તમારા ઘરમાં કોઈની હિસ્ટ્રી હોય તો યુ હેવ સીન દેટ ECG વેર PQRS ફેઝીસ આર દેટ. So as per that particular disturbance in particular disturbance in the heartbeat at particular point, for example, ke heartbeat disturbance takes place at P phase, suppose it is at Q phase, so according to that particular drugs are used for the treatment, and based on that this antiarrhythmic drugs are divided, classified. So class 1, that is sodium channel blocker, and the drugs are, that is disopyramide, then flecainide, lidocaine, maxiletine, then procainamide, propafenone, quinidine, tocainide. Here all this drug with that in bracket mention 1A, 1C, 1B, 1A, 1C, 1A, 1B, this is nothing but the particular phase where actual heartbeat disturbance takes place, that is seen in the ECG diagram. Okay, so this particular drugs are effective to treat that particular condition. Then class 2, that is beta adrenoreceptor blockers, or we can say it is beta blocker. So these three drugs are used most commonly, that is esmolol, metoprolol, then propranolol. And then next one, that is class 3 potassium channel blocker, amiodarone, then dofetilide, then sotalol. Then fourth one, that is calcium channel blockers, diltiazem, verapamil, and miscellaneous category, in that other antiarrhythmic drugs are used like adenosine, digoxin and all that. Now this antiarrhythmic drugs can be classified according to that predominant effect on the action potential. Now this action potential is nothing but the, it is related with that cardiac potential diagram, ECG. So at particular phase a problem is there, so to solve out that particular problem of action potential according to drugs are given. Here this particular classification, it's nothing but it's a Vaughan Williams classification of AAD, antiarrhythmic drug, and it is based on their effect on the cardiac action potential. So this is the valid one. If suppose question is asked in examination, give classification of antiarrhythmic drug, in that case you need to write down this particular classification. This is the actual classification for antiarrhythmic drugs as per action potential. Now we start one by one. Here now
आई एम सॉल्विंग योर कन्फ्यूजन कि दिस एंटी एरिथमिक ड्रग्स एक्शन पोटेंशियल. सो ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड यू कैन सी दैट एक्शन पोटेंशियल वेयर वेंट्रिकुलर एक्शन पोटेंशियल इज गिवन एंड इट शोज अ वेरी क्लियर कट चेंज इन द रिदम एंड द लाइन्स आर शोन लाइक ग्रीन रेड ब्लू एंड इफ एनी चेंजेस इन दिस पर्टिकुलर अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ड्रग्स आर गिवन. सो वी स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट वन क्लास वन. सो दिस एंटी अरेथमिक ड्रग्स एक्ट बाय ब्लॉकिंग वोल्टेज सेंसिटिव सोडियम चैनल्स via the same mechanism as local anesthetic because see in this particular drug whether it's a calcium channel blocker as well as a sodium channel blocker or beta blocker or like ACE inhibitors are not used but all this particular ABCD class of drugs they are used in all the category of drugs in that heart is involved. For example angiopectoris then anti-angina drug, anti-arrhythmic drug, diuretics, anti-hypertensive agent, then cardiovascular disease and all that. So all these particular disease conditions related with heart. So these four are the major category as anti-hypertensive, but at the same time, these particular drugs are used in all these conditions also because ultimately all these conditions related with heart or either disturbance in the rhythm of heart. Okay, so this is antiarrhythmic drugs act via sodium channel blocker blocking and the decrease rate of entry of sodium it slows the rate of rise of phase zero. Here in this case you can see ventricular action potential here it starts with phase zero and phase zero of the action potential. The drug is class 1A quinidine. This is obtained from the Cinchona bar and it is related with moderate sodium channel blocker. ERP, it's electron release potential. Then class 1B example is lidocaine. It is a weak sodium channel blocker. Then class 1C is flecainide, that is the strong sodium channel blocker. So here class wise, class 1 that is divided into ABC depending on the action. Blockage action of sodium channel blocking action and accordingly drugs are given. So this is the strong one flecainide whereas the weak one that is lidocaine and one example is given over here that is procainamide and this is the example of quinidine. So these are the drugs that is used for the treatment of heartbeat that is disturbance at this phase zero of the action potential. Here this is the synthesis for procainamide. Here you can see the final structure of procainamide in that it has NH2, here it is COO and this side chain. So according to that we have to select a particular starting material. So here we start with para-nitrobenzoic acid, that is the starting material. Now you focus with starting material as well as the final product. So here this is the starting material where NO2 group is there but final structure we need it NH2. So what we need to do, we need to convert this into NH2 via reduction. So when we do reduction of nitro functional group it will convert into NH2. Second part, this COOH here we need to convert into side chain. So that is only possible when we remove this OH with derivatization. So this COOH functional group that will interact first with SOCl2 so that COOH functional group is converted into what? COCl. Now to remove this OH directly it requires more energy and we need to do a little bit higher effort. So to avoid that we need to convert into COCl so that this Cl can be liberated very easily because it's a very good living group. So first convert into this one, then attach this side chain. Now here you can see this NH2CH2CNC2H5, this is nothing but N-diethyl ethanamine. So here this lone pair of nitrogen attack on carbonyl carbon and so Cl is liberated from this and whatever the positive charge generate over here due to this bond attack, that is nullify with what? Liberation of proton from here. So from this H is liberated, Cl is liberated from this position, so that HCl is liberated and we will have side chain on the right hand side. Now what left? Conversion of this NO2 group, that is reduction. So for that SnHCl is used for the reduction and so NO2 group is converted into NH2 and we will have propanamide as a drug. Next one, class 2 drugs. This class 2 drugs are beta blockers, propranolol, then S-butylol, sotalol, esmolol, timolol, metoprolol and etanolol. And basically all this beta adrenergic antagonists. Particularly this drug, how they act and at which particular phase. So this drug diminishes phase 4 depolarization. Depolarization, as we have already seen, it's related with the contraction. This drug diminishes phase 4 depolarization. See, contraction is good, but the hyperactive contraction, khench awa wala, that is not desirable. In that case, we use this drug and it reduces or diminishes phase 4 depolarization and thus depressing atomicity, prolonging AV conduction and decreasing heart rate and contractility. See here, decreasing heart rate, it doesn't mean that it is slow down less than 60, but whatever the raise heartbeat, that can be decreased. Okay, then class 2 agents are useful in treating tachycardias caused by increased sympathetic activity. Then they are also used for atrial flutter and fibrillation and for AV nodal reentrant tachycardia. So here is an example of one very good one, that is etanolol. This is the example, it's used for, or it falls under this category, and therapeutic use for this drug, mainly it is used for hypertension. It is also used in angina, then myocardial infarction, MI, then arrhythmias and heart failure. So these are the therapeutic use for beta blockers or beta blocking agents. Now the third number, class 3, here this is potassium channel blockers, that is also known as repolarization prolongators. It means resting, then contraction and again recharging. So to increase that period, automatically the contraction phase, that will be little bit decreased. So it is this is done via potassium channel blocking, and these are the drugs, amiodarone, then ibutylide, dofetylide, then britidium. So these are the drugs and mainly act by blocking potassium channel. It increases the refractory period. It also increases the duration without affecting phase 0 and resting membrane potential. So this is the example of amiodarone. This is the structure for that drug. Now the class 4 drug, that is known as calcium channel blockers. Now most important example for this calcium channel blockers are verapamil, diltiazem. This calcium channel blockers, they decrease the inward current carried by calcium. See, we have seen that when calcium influx, that activates actin and myosin protein and that is responsible for the contraction. This is the normal function, but somehow there is a disturbance in the function and these particular proteins are activated highly where they are responsible for hypercontraction. So for that reason, calcium channel blockers are used so that they decrease the inward current carried by calcium, means Ca+2, and resulting in a decreased rate of phase 4 spontaneous depolarization. Spontaneous means depolarization that we have seen, it's a contraction, and spontaneous means frequently, one by one. Okay. So drugs are used for that, diltiazem, verapamil, these two are the common drug for this category, and mainly used for the treatment of hypertension, systemic as well as pulmonary hypertension. Then this is also used for angina. This is also used for arrhythmia, arrhythmic condition also. Next one, other drugs. See, we have seen all these drugs class wise, class 1, 2, 3, 4. Other than this, miscellaneous drug that are also useful. So this is all about the classification of antiarrhythmic drug. This is most important from this chapter. Okay. So other drugs or miscellaneous category of drug to treat tachycardia or tachyarrhythmias, that is adenosine, that inhibits AV conduction and the duration of effect is less than 60 seconds. It is also used as an IV bolus in SV tachycardia with narrow QRS complex. Then adverse drug reaction, that is bradycardia and AV blockage. If excess of use, then this may happen. Okay. Then next one is the digoxin. It reduces conduction through the AV node, and it is also useful in the control of atrial flutter and atrial fibrillation. So here are the adenosine drug and its uses to treat tachycardia or tachyarrhythmias. Then next one, the clinical uses, sodium channel blockers. They are also useful as a local anesthetic as well as anticonvulsions. Then procainamide, it can be used to treat atrial fibrillation in the settings of Wolff Parkinson's White syndrome. Then supraventricular arrhythmia, then nodal and ventricular arrhythmia, then refractory ventricular arrhythmias. So here are the different chambers it working. It's again similar to the previous one. Then the side effects that is also associated with that antiarrhythmic drug. If we use this particular drug in a higher dose, then that may lead to side effects. So here a few side effects that is related with antiarrhythmic drugs, that is worsening arrhythmias, then allergic reaction, then it may also cause chest pain, fainting, then swelling of the feet or legs, blood vision, shortness of breath, then abnormally fast heartbeat or abnormally slow heartbeat. Then pacemaker, as we have discussed the role of pacemaker, generally it is used to control heartbeat or control or regulate the heartbeat. So a pacemaker is a small device that's placed in the chest or abdomen to help control abnormal heart rhythm. This device uses low energy electric pulses to prompt the heart to beat at a normal rate. So pacemakers are used to treat arrhythmia, and arrhythmias are problem with the rate of rhythm or the heartbeat. So here this pacemaker having the role to treat arrhythmic condition or normalize the heart beat. Next one is the class 1. Here again this is a overview of all this drug that we have already discussed, where class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4 drugs for the treatment of arrhythmic conditions. Okay, so this is all about classification. Thank you very much. So I think this is very crystal clear to all of you about classification and how heart functioning, heart rhythm, normal range, if below range or higher range, then what happen, which particular drugs are used as per action potential. So this is all about antiarrhythmic drug. So most important questions from this particular chapter or the particular topic is write a note on antiarrhythmic drugs. And the second most important question, that is give classification of antiarrhythmic drug. So these two questions are the most important from this category, that is antiarrhythmic drug.